हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू के एल एस गुप्ते कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स बेलगावी। माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एस बी वेंडिगेरी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, टेकिंग ऑनलाइन रिविजन क्लासेस फॉर सिक्स सेमिस्टर स्टूडेंट्स। एज वी स्टार्टेड ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, टुडे लेट अस हैव ए डिस्कशन ऑन द कंटिन्यूड पार्ट ऑफ द नेशनल इनकम, that is reasons for slow growth of national income. In my previous online class I have completed the meaning and components of national income and methods of calculating national income, and today let us have a brief discussion on the reasons for slow growth of national income. Especially India's national income has not increased up to mark till 2010. It is because of several reasons. In the beginning, when we were there in the hands of British rule, colonial rule was not given any importance for Indian economic development in case of agriculture, industry and tertiary sector. Because of that, the national income of the country was not increased in those days. And even after independence, there was no importance given for agriculture and also industrial sector and tertiary sector. Because of that, India's national income was not increased. Even today, the national income of the country was increased in a slowest manner because of several reasons. The first reason for slow growth of national income is fluctuations in agriculture production. Especially India's agriculture is playing gambling with monsoon rains. 40% of India's land is depends on dry land, and 20% of the land is partly irrigated, and remaining 40% of land is fully irrigated. Because of that, India's national income is not increased in case of agriculture sector. The contribution towards national income from agriculture sector is very less, and most of the agriculture farmers were not properly educated, and they are not able to adopt modified technology and organic farming in their agriculture sector. Because of that, the contribution towards national income was very less even in pre-90s and also post-1990s. Coming to the second cause for slow growth of national income, that is a slow or poor industrial growth. Especially industrial sector is a capital oriented sector, but India is labor oriented. Because of that, there is a lack of capital formation to invest in industrial sector. So because of that, the contribution towards national income from industrial sector is also less. Because of that, national income was very less in India. Coming to the next important cause for the slow growth of national income, that is a resource constraint. It means limitations in inputs available to complete the process of production. Especially in all three sectors, the inputs which are required for the process of production are very less. The demand is more, but the availability of input is very less. Because of that, the national income of the country is slowing down at present. Coming to the next important reason for slow growth of national income is a higher capital output ratio. First, we shall understand what is the meaning of capital output ratio. It means it is the value of investment and the value of output. It shows the ratio of investment to the ratio of output. Example, if we are investing 32% of investment, and by that investment, if we reach 8% of GDP, it means that we are able to produce 1 unit of output by investing 4 units of capital. So when we are investing more amount of capital to produce less units of goods and services, that is called as high capital output ratio. Due to this high capital output ratio, one side investment of the country goes on increased, and other side there was no increase in the total output or else GDP. Coming to the next point, that is growth in population. Especially India is the richest country in the world in case of population, but its inhabitants are very poor. For every 1.5 second, 2 babies are born in India. For every hour, 13,000 babies are born in India. And for an year, in 1 year, 1.98 crore population increase in India, and in 1 decade, that is in 10 years, the total population of the country goes on increasing by 10.98 crore. It means that India's population is increasing like jerks, like steps fashion. If you are taking example of UP and Bihar population, UP and Bihar population is equivalent to Indonesia country's population. The total population of the country is equivalent to North American and African countries' total population. So because of that rapid growth in population of the country, there is no possibility of increasing the national income, because per capita income of the country is calculated by total income of the country divided by total population. If the national income is less than the total population of the country, it shows slow growth in total national income of the country. Coming to the next cause for the slow growth of national income, that is old and worn out capital. Especially India's capital, whatever capital investment is there, that is inefficient or else what we call it as deficient capital. So due to lack of efficient capital, there is no possibility of increasing the total national income of the country. Coming to the next one, that is socio-political condition. In India, when we are talking about the social atmosphere, India is known for its own culture, its own civilization, its own religious beliefness. They believe in God, they believe in male child, they never believe in development of the country. So because of these family restrictions, even today most of the rural families are not coming over, they are not showcasing their personal talent, and they are restricted with their own family occupation. Because of that, national income of the country goes on declines. Now coming to the next and last reason for the slow growth of national income, that is a decrease in the life expectancy. Life expectancy showcases that the number of years human being is living on the earth. Especially India's life expectancy as per 2020 census, that is only 69.27 years. In India, each human being is living for only not more than 70 years. As compared to the developed countries, life expectancy ratio, that is 75 to 85 years. It is also most important variable, what we call it as variable to calculate total national income of the country. So these are all the reasons for slow growth of national income. Coming to the next part of the national income, that is difficulties in calculation of national income. National income is a mathematical device to calculate economic growth of the country. The accurate growth of the country can be calculated only with the help of total national income of the country. But the problem is how to calculate the accurate national income of the country. There are many difficulties in countries like India and other Asian continental countries. Basically, in Asian continental countries, it is very difficult to calculate national income because of several reasons. Coming to the first difficulty to calculate national income is, that is non-monetary transactions. Non-monetary transactions means the small vendors, street vendors or also small vendors, they are not able to maintain their records and data of their activities. Because of that, it is not possible to calculate national income accurately. If they are not able to provide the data information of their activities, it is very difficult to calculate national income. Coming to the next one, the next difficulty of calculating national income is a problem of double counting. Double counting means when the product is coming under the calculation for more than one time or less two times, for example. Take the example of cotton. Cotton is a product which is using in a different form for different activities. In the beginning stage, cotton is using as a thread, for example. After thread it becomes lint, after lint it becomes raw cloth, and after raw cloth it becomes the ready-made garment. If you are taking the values of all these stages of the cotton, it is not accurate calculation of the national income. Either we should take the value of cotton or else we should take the value of the ready-made garment. So such kind of possibilities are there in case of double counting. Double counting never provide accuracy of calculation of national income. Coming to the next point, that is the underground economy. Underground economy is nothing but black marketing. Black marketing means what? It is not comes under the government registration. It is not comes under the government taxes. Whatever activity is done, those activities are not comes under the calculation of government taxes. That is called as the underground economy or else black marketing. It means what? Black marketing is also one of the major difficulty to calculate the national income of the country. Coming to the next important difficulty for calculation of national income is petty production. Petty production means micro level activities, micro, small and medium level activities, like for example pawn shop, like Xerox machine, okay, like grocery shop. Whatever income comes from these activities is not recorded in national income. So if it is not comes under the calculation of national income, we are not able to calculate the accurate national income of the country. Coming to the next one, income from different professions. Most of the time we see a single person, a single human being is engaging in two or more activities. Take the example of primary school teacher. If a primary school teacher is working as a teacher from morning 10 to 5 o'clock, after 5 o'clock, if he is having one grocery shop from 6 to 10, the income from that grocery shop is not comes under the calculation of national income. So his income from teacher is comes under the national income, but the income which is earned by himself after the school hours, that is from grocery shop, which is not comes under the calculation of national income. Because of that, it is also one major difficulty in calculating national income. Coming to the next one, that is no proper availability of data and records. As we seen in agriculture sector, most of the agriculture farmers are illiterates. They are not able to maintain the data of their activities, and the transaction takes place between the farmers is only in terms of kinds, not in terms of money transactions, or it's in value terms, or it's in price terms. If the transaction takes place between the farmers in kinds, or it's in goods and services, it is not comes under the calculation of national income. So here, due to lack of availability of statistical data and records, we are not able to calculate national income of the country. Coming to another important difficulty for the calculation of national income is public services. Public services means most of the times human being is providing services without any expectations. When we are providing services without any expectations, that is also not comes under the calculation of national income. And next point is illiteracy and ignorance. Especially more than 74% of India's population is illiterate. Remaining 26% of India's population is completely illiterate, and they are not able to maintain the records of their activities, and they are not able to maintain the statistical information of their activities. And ignorance means they are not interested to maintain the records of their activities. It is also partially responsible for difficulty of calculating national income. Coming to the next point, that is wages and salaries which are paid in terms of kinds or goods and services. Especially rural agricultural laborers, whatever work they are providing, whatever service they are providing to the agriculture farmers, they expect their returns, their payments, either in terms of money or else in terms of kinds or goods and services. If the wages paid to the workers are in terms of kinds or goods and services, that is not comes under the calculation of national income. Coming to the next one, that is transfer payments. Transfer payments means the government of any country is a welfare government which provide welfare activities, welfare services to the human being and public, and the subsidies, scholarships, concessions, relaxations are also the examples of transfer payments. These transfer payments are not comes under the calculation of national income. In addition to these difficulties, there are other difficulties to calculation national income. Calculation of national income are second-hand transactions, environmental damages, calculation of depreciation, and inadequate and unreliable statistical information. These are the basic difficulties of calculation of national income. With this, we'll stop today's online revision class for the sixth semester students. And with this, the national income topic is completed. And the next topic we shall discuss in the next online class. Till then, take care, be safe, stay at home, wear mask, and maintain social distancing. Thank you very much.